أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أهلا وسهلا إلى مركز العلوم والحكمة Remote Study. Welcome to 25th part of our lesson series from the book titled A Daily Tahfiz Booklet. I am Mudaris Sulaiman Ali. Happy listening. We are still learning from Surah Al-Fajr. Surah Al-Fajr. In this part of the lessons, we are going to learn how to recite Surah Al-Fajr from verse 25. To verse 30. Learning to recite Surah Al-Fajr from verse 25 to verse 30. Now we can start. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. I read it from here. Fayaw ma'idhi. Normally, you are supposed to read it as fayaw ma'idhin. Fayaw ma'idhin. However, it is more accurate to read it as fayaw ma'idhi. La, because of this lamu carrying shadda, after this dhalun carrying double kasra. Fayaw ma'idhi. La yu'adhibu aynun. Read your aynun as much as you can from the center of the throat. La yu'adhibu. This dhalun. You read your dhalun by placing the tip of the tongue under the edge of your front teeth. Then dhalun is pronounced correctly. La yu'adhibu. Adha, adha. The same principle is applicable here. Adha bahu. This symbol written on top of this small wawun is telling you, draw the letter before me very well. Adha bahu. Ahade. Ahade. Normally you are supposed to read it as ahad. Ahad. However, it is more accurate to read it as ahade. Ahade. The reason why I will tell us in level 3 of this course, inshallah. Fayawma idhi la yu'adhibu adhabahu ahade. Fayawma idhi la yu'adhibu. This is your value. You read it with stress because of shadda written on top of it. La yu'adhibu adhabahu ahade. Fayawma idhi la yu'adhibu adhabahu ahade. Now from here. Wala yuthiku. Yuthiku. Remember how to read your fa'un, 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 fa'un. So you read your fa'un by placing the tip of your tongue on the edge of your front teeth. Fa-fi-thu, fa-fi-thu, on the back edge of your front teeth. You place the tip of your tongue on the back edge of your front teeth. Then fa'un is pronounced correctly. Fa, fi, thu, as in thank you, thank you. Wala, yuthi, yuthiku. Watha, kohu, ahade. Here is wawu maddin, saying, draw the letter before me. Fu maddin, also saying, draw the letter before me. Wala, yuthiku. Watha, you draw it. Watha, kohu, And this symbol saying, draw the letter before me very well. وثاقه أحد. This حاؤل. حاؤل. As in happy. Happy. حاؤل in Quranic inscription. ولا يوثق وثاق أحد. ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد. Verse 27. Now reading from here. Ya. You draw it very well. Ya. Ayyatuha nafsul. Ya. Ayyatuha nafsul. You have nunun shadda here. So you read your nunun with that special tune. As in uncle. يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة مطمئنة مطمئنة. Normally you are supposed to read it as mot 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 mot. However, it is more accurate to read it as mot مطمئنة. You are having nunun shadda here. So you read your nunun with shadda, with that special sound, that special tone, as in uncle, uncle, mutma'inna. So this is your ramta, you turn it to ha'un sukun for stopping. Mutma'inna. Ya ayyatuhan. أيتها النفس المطمئنة. يا أيتها النفس النفس. This is su connected with this lam sukun. نفس المطمئنة. يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة. Now verse 28, starting with Alif al-Wasl. Alif al-Wasl. You remember Alif al-Wasl? What I said about Alif al-Wasl in level 1 of this course. I told us that if you are starting a verse with this Alif al-Wasl, which has small sawdun written on it. Alif al-Wasl has small sawdun written on it. Now you are starting a verse with Alif al-Wasl. Alif al-Wasl has no fataha, no kasra, no dumma, meaning has no a sound, no e sound, and no u sound. So how do you now read it? I told us, you count your letters, starting with Alif al-Wasl itself. 1. Ra'un, 2. Jimun, 3. If this your third letter is carrying kasra, give Alif al-Wasl kasra. You read Alif al-Wasl with kasra. If the third letter is carrying kasra or fatha, I told us in level 1. If the third letter is carrying kasra or fatha, you read the Alif al-Wasl with kasra. If it is carrying dumma, you read Alif al-Wasl with dumma. If it is carrying kasra or fatha, read Alif al-Wasl with kasra. If it is dumma, you read it with dumma. Now we are going to read this Alif al-Wasl with kasra. Ir, ir, jiri, not ar, and not ur, rather ir, ir, jiri. You draw it very well because of this symbol. Ila, rabbiki, ra, driyatam, ra, dri, this dodun. Don't say ra, di, not dalun kasra, di, this ra, dri. You now have to read your dodun by placing the edge of your tongue on the edge of your right molar teeth. Then dodun is pronounced. Do, dri, do. Do, dri, do. Ra, driyatam. You must allow the sound of this mimun to reflect in this taun with double fatha. Ra, driyatam, tam. Ra, driyatam. marvelous in level 3 of this course. Irjii ila rabbiki radiyatan marjiya irjii ila rabbiki radiyatan marjiya. Verse 29. Fadehuli. Normally you are supposed to read it as fad. However, it is more accurate to read it as fadehuli. The reason why I'll tell us in level 3. Fadehuli fi ibadi. Fadehuli fi ibadi. فَدَخُولِي فِي عِبَادِي وَدَخُولِي جَنَّتِي وَدَخُولِي جَنَّتِي وَدَخُولِي جَنَّتِي. Okay, now I'm going to read the verses once again as an expert. Try as much as you can to identify the letters and listen attentively. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Read it from here. فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد. Read it from here. ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد. Now read it from here. يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة. Verse 28 from here. ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية. Verse 29 from here. فادخلي في عبادي فادخلي في عبادي فادخلي في عبادي. Now verse 30. وادخلي جنتي وادخلي جنتي وادخلي جنتي. لعلك فهمت. I hope you understand. ما شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Kindly like the video, share it, and hit the subscribe button below. مع السلامة وإلى اللقاء آخر.